Creating geometric patterns, the starting point is a perfect circle, followed by secondary circles of different sizes, interlaced together, and connected intersections with straight lines. They are based on repetition of a single motif, and with the help of grid of squares, hexagons, or triangles, are designed in a way to fit all together in a perfect sequence. So let's go ahead and lay down the foundation using these different geometric shapes and create one. So we are going to start off by creating a circle with six intersecting lines. And the easiest way to do this is by using the Polygrid tool. So go to the line segment tool, click and hold till you get this flat menu, and go all the way down and select the Polygrid tool. Now double click on that to bring up the Polygrid tool options. So first we got the width and the height, followed by these concentric dividers. These concentric dividers are the number of circles that will be on the Polygrid, or in other words, the rings. And after that, we got the radial dividers, which are the lines that will come out from the center, or in other words, the spokes. So I'm just going to click OK, and I'm going to do this interactively. So I'm going to click and drag. And I want to show you that before you release the mouse, you can actually add concentric dividers. So you can do this by using the up arrow key, or if you want to remove these rings, you can press the down arrow key. If you want to add the spokes, press the right arrow key, and if you want to remove the spokes, press the left arrow key. Okay, just something to keep in mind. I'm just going to delete that, and then I'm going to make sure that on the view menu you have the smart guides on. It will help us tremendously align things around. I'm going to hold down the alt key or the option key on the Mac, and I'm going to go where it says around the center right here. I'm going to click once. And we've got the options here. I'm going to go for 400 by 400. For concentric dividers, I'm going to go for 0. And for the spokes, I'm going to go for 12, because if you remember earlier, we want to have a circle with six intersecting lines. So I'm just going to click OK. Now, if you want to make sure that this is centered, which it is, you can actually go to the Align menu here where it says Align to Artboard. And I align this horizontally and vertically. As you can see, nothing moved because we did a pretty good job. Okay, so now let's continue creating more intersecting lines. So for that, I'm going to use the Polygon tool. I'm going to click once here, and I'm going to create a hexagon. I want to have a radius of 200. I'm just going to click OK. Right? Now let's create more intersecting lines. I'm going to click here again in the middle, which is anchor. And this time, I'm going to go for a triangle. So select the rotate tool. Now make sure that the pivot point is right here in the middle, right there. It's going to snap just right there, and then click and drag, and it's going to snap right there. Okay. All right. Now back to the Polygon tool. I'm going to click and drag this time and create interactively a triangle. It's going to snap right there too, and I think that's all we need for intersecting lines. Okay. So I'll go to the layers here, shift select all these paths. We're going to go for opacity down to 40%, and then we're going to lock all these paths. Then I'm going to use the pen tool. I'm going to click once where it says anchor, and then right here where it says intersect, I'm going to click and drag, and then I'm going to hold down the shift key, and I'm going to stop till I see this path. Okay, release, and then just click once here. Now, before you change the tool, just hold down the Control key or the Command key on the Mac to deselect. Release the mouse to continue using the same tool, the pen tool. Click on the anchor here once, and then click where it says intersect, click and drag. Hold down the Shift key as you do till you see again the path, like so. Release, and then let's close the path. You're going to see this circle right next to the pen tool. That means close path, and just click once. There we go. Okay. Let's give it a color. Now, I don't want to have a fill, I just want to have a stroke. So let's get rid of the fill, to only have the stroke, which is okay, which is red. Select that. And then let's double click on the rotate tool. Let's have the preview on. I'm going to go for 60 degrees, but we need to have a copy of that. Click once. Then select the same on the first path here, double click, we're going to go for minus 60, and then of course another copy. And here's the pattern, it's getting coming along here. Now I'm going to click and drag and to this new layer icon and duplicate this. I'm going to lock this guy here, this group. I'm going to double click to rename this. That will be pattern. Hit enter, return. And then from this group here, I don't have this group. Okay, no need for that. Delete that. I don't need also these triangles. Delete those two. Then select all of these pattern here. Alt-Shift, Option-Shift of the Mac. Size is down. Let's say along like that. Select that. Object menu, pattern, and make. Okay. All right, zoom in here. So what do I need to do? Well, first I'm going to give a pattern a name. That will be geometric pattern. Let's say geometric pattern one. Then we've got the tile type. Grid, brick by row, brick by column. I'm going to go for hex by row. And then I'm going to check what is the size tile to art, because I want to have control over the horizontal spacing and the vertical spacing. So place the mouse right here and use the up arrow keys or the down arrow keys to change these numbers, okay? So I'm going to go for, let's say, minus one here. And for vertical spacing, I'm going to up this till lines like that, okay? I'm going to leave the overlap as it is. Copies is okay for me for the default 5x5. You can certainly change those. And I'm going to click Done. Okay. Double click the Zoom tool to zoom in 100%. Let's lock this guy here, the pattern. Let's make that invisible, create a new layer here. And let's select the rectangle tool here. I'm going to click and drag, create one. And I'm going to fill this with color. Red is okay. Go to the swatches, and here's the pattern we created, geometric pattern one. Click once to fill this. Okay, see, it looks pretty good. Now, in the event that you want to edit this, you can just double click, and, well, I need to zoom in a bit here. Select the hexagon, this one. And what I want to do is I'm going to go for the stroke, the weight of the stroke, I'm going to go for 0.5. There we go. Okay, I'm going to click done, and as you can see, this already worked. Okay. Zoom out. And here's our pattern. Geometric patterns play a big role in creative projects, and since they are based on connecting intersections between circles and lines, all you have to do is to create your own shapes and follow similar techniques. This concludes this lecture, and thank you for watching Third Elementary Tutorials.